Amen. Come on, let's just give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. Give the Lord glory. Give the Lord honor on this blessed day. Another day's journey, and we're glad about it. Amen. God has been good to us. God has been kind to us. Been gracious unto us. Keeps on blessing us over and over again. Another Lord's day. And he get all the praise. He get all the glory. He get all the honor. We welcome you to the Greater Mount Carmel Missionary Baptist Church, located 3835 Whitewater Road, right here in the city of Valdosta, Georgia, where God is doing great and awesome things, and he's truly worthy to be praised. Amen. Who wouldn't serve a God like this? Amen. Just lean over and ask somebody, say, neighbor, are you all right? Amen. 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 To God be the glory for the things that he has done. This time, we're going to ask that minister, Samantha Sheraton, will come and lead us in a word of prayer.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
It is a privilege and a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Good morning, saints. Amen. I know it's raining outside, but if we had to go to work, praise God, we'll be getting up early in the morning to go to our jobs, praise God. Good morning, saints. It is a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Good morning, saints. Hey, Papa, see Jehovah, Yekosa. Hey, God been good to us. I don't know about you this morning, but I'm going to tell God thank you this morning, because he's been mighty good to me this morning. Brought me a mighty long way this morning. Couldn't be here without him. Amen, somebody. Father God, we thank you this morning. I want to thank you this morning. I want to praise you this morning. I want to bless your name this morning. I want to glorify you this morning. I just want to thank you for everything that you're doing in our life, God, this morning. How you brought us from over here to over there, God. How you showed me the other day. Look around you. Look around you. Look where I brought you from. Thank you, Father God. Like millionaires, and we don't even know it, God. We're not looking and living like we used to live. We're living better than we ever lived. And I thank you, God, for it, God. Not one car, not two cars, not three cars, not four cars, but many cars in our driveway this morning. Once upon a time, it wasn't no cars that we could drive. Lord, I thank you, Lord. Food on our table, clothes on our back, shoes on our feet, God. I want to tell you thank you this morning, God. Thank you for allowing us to be in your sanctuary one more time, and not in the hospital, God. Not on our sick bed, God. Thank you this morning, God. We serve a mighty God this morning, God. A God that provides everything for us, God. Look out for us. Protect us on the highways and the byways. Protect us in the streets, God. Protect us in our homes, God. I want to say thank you this morning, God. I just want to glorify you, God. I came to worship you in spirit and in truth, God. I came to worship you, God. I came to thank you, God, and bless your holy name, God. Father God, you alone is El Shaddai, God. God, El Shaddai, God. God, El Shaddai, God. My mighty provider, God. God, our way maker, God. Our deliverer, God. God, I ask that whatever we need today, God, do it for us, God. Touch us in a mighty way, God. From head to toe, God. Whatever we've been leaning and praying about, God. Hear our prayers this morning, God. Touch our hearts this morning, God. Teach us how to love one another. Love abundantly. Love like you, God. God, not on the surface love, but God, the real love, God, that's poured out through you, God. God, teach us how to do just that, God. If we don't know how to love, we are nothing, God. We are nothing, God. Love is everything, God. And God, we pray for our sick. We pray for this world, God. We pray for the world's world war that's going on, God. Our babies and our children and our parents dying, God. We lift them up in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We can't do nothing without you, God. But through you and with you, with us, God, we can do all things. We more than conquerors, God. God, let your spirit have its way in this place, God. Touch the musicians. Touch the choir. Touch us. Touch the man of God. Touch our families. Touch everybody that's here. Touch those that's not here. In the mighty name of Jesus, God. We can't do it, God. You only one can do it for us, God. Touch us in a mighty way, God. And let us worship you in spirit and in truth. Let it not be about us, God, but be about you in your spirit. In Jesus' name, we give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. And every heart say amen. Huh? Uh-huh. Amen, Lord Jesus, this morning. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus.
We're gonna walk. Today. To our members who are celebrating birthdays in the month of December, we'd like to say happy birthday. If you would, if you're a part of the December birthday month, please meet in the foyer after services today to have your group pictures. Sunday, December 17th, 2023, the Rocky Hill Church of God in Christ will host their 2023 Christmas Cantata at 10:30 a.m. The Mount Calvary Music Ministry, choirs, and Mount Calvary Church family have been invited to participate in this great event. The church is located at 6595 Rocky Hill Church Road in Hayhira, Georgia. Also on December December 17th, the Mount Calvary Baptist Church Singles Ministry will host their Christmas Gala. This event will be held at 3 o'clock p.m. that day at the Performing Arts Center at 3101 Barack Obama Road. The cost is $20. If you would like to attend this awesome event, please see Sister Edna Jones. Sunday, December 31st, 2023, Mount Calvary will host our Watch Night Holy Ghost service. This will be an in-person service at 10:45 p.m. We encourage you and your family to come out as we give God gratitude for bringing us through 2023 and praising Him for allowing us to cross over to 2024. It is going to be a wonderful year, 2024, and we are excited to start off with some new things. First, we will be going back to our first Sunday choir. And the first rehearsal will be Tuesday, January 30th, 2024, at 6 o'clock p.m. If you have any questions or need more information, please contact our Minister of Music, Sister Shaquanta Hogan, and you can see her after services, or feel free to call her at 229-740-1065. Ladies of Calvary, the Sister to Sister Ministry will be attending the Transformation Conference on March 15th and 16th, 2024. We're asking that all ladies that plan to attend to please sign up by January 31st, 2024. Please give your name to either Sister Gloria James or Deaconess Lily Roberts. Those are our announcements for today. And just to leave you with just a little thought for the week, is that Christians, we are meant to forgive. If you're struggling with forgiving someone, a family or a friend, just focus on how many times God has forgiven us. Thank you, and I hope you have an awesome day.
How did I make it all these years? How did I make it this far? Through the valley and over the hills, I knew it had to be God. How did I make it through the storm? And how did I make it through the rain? If you want to know just how I got here, it's so easy to explain. Say it was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace. By the grace of God.
Said it was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
I made it this far. By the grace.
Lord, I thank you for how you brought me through the night, and Lord, you kept me, and you never left me, you stood by my side. There were so many times I came so close. Oh man, devil, he tried to take me in, For the reason I'm here, it's not hard for me to see. In fact, it's so easy for me to explain. Say it was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
How you brought me through the night, and Lord, you kept me, and you never left me. You stood by my side. There were so many times I came so close. Oh man, them he tried to take me, but the reason I'm here. It's not hard for me to see. In fact, it's so easy for me to explain. Said it was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
When I strayed away, even though I knew the word, still I was no faith. But it was His mercy and His grace that carried me and brought me on the way. Said it was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing. It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
His amazing grace.
God's grace.
I made it this far.
I made it this far. By the grace of God.
One more time. It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God's grace.
It was God's grace.
God some glory. Give God some honor this morning. Amen. By the grace of God that we made it this far. If it wasn't for the grace of God, we would have not made it thus far. But God's grace keeps on blessing us over and over and over again. Oh, His amazing grace. Hallelujah. We give God the praise, give God the glory, give God the honor on this morning to God. Be the praise to God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit on this morning to our ministerial staff, Minister Holmes, Minister Mike Dougal in his absence, Minister McCaugan, Minister Sheraton, amen, and to also glad to have Minister Katie Williams with us on this morning, to their spouses, to my lovely spouse this morning, Lady Evelyn Diane Vincent, to all of God's people, our deacons, deaconess, mothers, saints, and friends. It's just good to be in the number one more time. Amen. Lift up the name of Jesus. Amen. Because God has truly been good to us. Out of St. Luke's Gospel, the 18th chapter and verse number 1. Amen. St. Luke's Gospel, 18th chapter and verse number 1. Amen. And He spake a parable unto them to this, and to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint, saying, there was and a city adjudged, which feared not God, neither regarded man. And there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him, saying, Avenge me of mine adversary. And he would not for a while, but after he had said unto himself, Though I fear not God, nor regard man, yet because the widow troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. And the Lord said, Amen. Hear what the unjust judge said, and shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them? I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth? Father God, we thank you. Father God, we give you praise. God, we give you honor. We thank you for all the many blessings you have bestowed upon us. God, you keep on blessing us over and over again. God, you brought us all week long to this present time. Lord, you allowed our golden moments to roll on. We thank you this morning. Thank you for another day's journey. God, we thank that you brought us to the last first Sunday in 2023. And God, we give you praise and we give you glory for that. We thank you that we had a mind to come and worship. Thank you for the place to worship. Thank you for the place called Mount Calvary on this morning, Father. And Lord, we pray, Lord, you give us preaching and teaching power. Keep us near the cross in the mighty name of Jesus. And we give your name the praise, give your name the glory, and we'll give your name the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Clap the hand you love the Lord on this morning. Amen. Amen. God get all the praise. He get all the glory. And he gets all of the honor. Amen. Been good to us. Well, we ought to be glad about. I say we ought to be glad about what the Lord is doing for us. Amen. Out of St. Luke's Gospel, 18th chapter, verses 1 through 8, I want to talk with you from this text on this morning. Amen. The power of persistence over resistance. The power of persistence over resistance. Yeah, have you ever, amen, given up too soon? And maybe you were trying to learn to play, amen, perhaps the piano or the guitar, any another language, or perhaps something totally out of your comfort zone. You worked on it for a few months but gave up. Maybe you tried to learn a new skill, lose weight. Let me clear my throat on that. Lose weight and get in shape. But for whatever reason, you gave up before you saw the results. Persistence is about staying on course of action in spite of difficulties or opposition. Staying on course. My flesh wants to give up, but my spirit won't let me. Y'all don't hear me? That's a spiritual persistence. Persistence is an important part of success. Deacon Moran's stories abound of men and women who were persistent in their goals. They refused to give up. They followed their, amen, dream when all their friends and family said to them to quit. They found success because they were persistent. There are also many others who fail because of the lack of persistence. Life rewards those who are what? Persistent. Who never give up. Who continue until they complete the course. Sometimes our prayers life. Sometimes our prayer life lacks persistence. Yeah, I bring my query request to God with great vigor and fervor today, but by tomorrow I've forgotten about my prayer and have moved on to other things. We are so easily distracted. We so easily lose our focus. Some of y'all, man, already on your collard greens at home. Can I get a witness? Some of y'all still stuck on the Georgia-Alabama game. Have mercy, Lord. We take our eyes off the prize. We're persuaded that is not going to happen. We get off track of our God-designed destiny. Yeah, it didn't happen quick enough, so oh well. I'm through with it. See you later, alligator. After a while, I know somebody knew what I was talking about. Yeah, have you ever prayed for something, but when the answer didn't come immediately, you forgot about it, or you just quit praying? Huh. But persistent prayer is that it doesn't give up. It's praying for something until God either answer our prayer or tell us to stop praying. Persistent prayer is standing on and standing in faith that God will answer your prayer. It never stops until it receives an answer from God. Can I help somebody this morning? That God honors, God honors, God honors persistent prayer. I say he honors persistent prayer. Yeah, and somebody need to know this morning that God honors those persistent prayer, the power of persistence over resistance. I come to tell you that you're going to have some resistance. You're going to have some oppositions. You're going to have some naysayers. You're going to have some difficulties. You're going to have some bridges to cross. You're going to have some rivers to go through. You're going to have some good days, and you're going to have some bad days. But you got to have a made-up mind that I'm going to be persistent over the resistance. Yeah, the power in persistence over the resistance. I come to tell you, Brother McCargo, persistent prayer honors God. Persistent prayer is a confession that I will seek what I need only from the hand of God. Yeah, when I bring my need to him, I am saying that he is the source of all that I need. Yeah, he is the source of all that I need, because the Bible says, but my God shall supply. Y'all don't hear me this morning. Yeah, the persistent prayer says, I will look to God for every need that I have. I'm not looking to man. I'm not looking to the government. I'm not looking to family or friend, but I'm looking to God, the author and the finisher of my faith. I will continue to look to this for him for my supply. I will continue to pray until God answers me. I'm not only praying. Y'all need to catch this. I'm not only praying, Sister James, until something happens, but I'm also praying to God answers. I mean, I might need to say this to somebody over, amen, the praise team. I need to hear this. I'm not just praying until something happens, but I'm praying until God answers. Persistent prayer honor God by confessing that he is the supply. He will answer my prayer on God's timetable. Persistent prayer is a statement of faith that my loving God will answer my prayer some way, somehow. Somebody say, well, Pastor, what do you mean to God? And sometimes God says yes. Sometimes he say no. And then other times he says, not right now. We have to understand and be by to God's will and to God's purpose. See, it's always not going to go the way you think it's going to go. But long as God gonna give you an answer, whatever the answer is, you learn to accept the answer that God gives you. But God honor your persistence prayer. He honors that because he see you coming day in and day out. Somebody say, "But I've been praying for this and praying for this." But honey, don't stop praying. Keep praying. Persistent prayer. Point number two. I'm already at point number two. Y'all better watch me. I'm gonna leave you this morning. Point number two, persistent prayer reveals our commitment. Not only does it honor God and say that God is all our supply and whatever we need, God got it, but persistent prayer, it reveals our commitment. Often we bring fleeting prayers to the Lord. We pray today but forget to pray tomorrow. We pray our request to God today, but we never bring it up again. We say, well, I pray for that. I ain't going to bring that back up again. No, you need to keep on. Persistence, prayer is committed continually, asking God until he answers. I will not give up. I will not quit. I will not try. I will not try other things, but I'm going to wait on the Lord. I will pray and believe God. I will bring my prayer to God every day until he tells me yes, no, or not now or later. The Gospel of Luke reveals to us this morning the insight of what Jesus thinks about persistent prayer. Verse number 1, Jesus says to the disciple, parable shows them that they should always pray and not give up, not faint. Faint. Amen. This is not a fainting season. I said, this is not a fainting season, but it's a faith season. I said, this is not a fainting season, but it's a faith season. Yeah, we need to understand that it ain't time for us to faint and fall out and give up. But he said we ought to always pray. I always tell you that prayer is always in order. He tells the story of a woman in the parable who comes before a judge asking for justice against her enemy. And in an unrighteous man who doesn't care about God, the people. But since she continues, she's persistent. Every chance she got, your honor. 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 Can I help somebody this morning? What you're praying for, what you believe in God for. When you get up in the morning, say, Lord, thank you for it. Lord, thank you for it. When the crumb crosses your mind, say, Lord, I want to thank you for it. Lord, when you go to bed, I want to thank you for it. While you're saying your grace over your food, I want to thank you for it. When the devil tell you no, I want to thank you for it. When you don't see it coming your way, I want to thank you for it. When there is no way, I want to thank you for it. Keep it before your Lord and keep it in prayer. She was persistent. Keep bringing up before the judge. And Jesus explains that the Lord, amen, the Lord said, listen to what the unjust just says. He is an unjust judge. And he will he not bring about justice for the ones that he has chosen? God loves us, who cry to him day and night. Will he keep not putting them off? I tell you, amen, he will see that he get justice and quickly. God says, if you keep on coming to him, I'm going to do something for you. If the unjust judge can do right, and I'm God, and you my child. Woo! What I'm gonna do for you? Y'all don't hear me? Amen. You belong to me. You serve me. I made you in my own image. I created you. I put you on this earth. If I don't do it for you, it won't be done. God said that if the president can do something for you, I'm God. I made everything. Hallelujah. I created everything. I said, let there be, and it was. You don't think I'll do the same thing for you? I get in a hurry because you belong to me. You're my child. I'm going to come to you in a hurry. But don't you dare give up. Don't you dare give up. Keep being persistent. If an unjust judge would give a poor woman what she thinks asks because she comes to him every day, he got tired of her coming. Honey, he got tired. Say, child, here she come again. Can you imagine? Here she come again. You know, it's just like being married. Y'all don't hear me? Yeah. You know, husband. Can I talk to the husband? Y'all can look at me. Don't look at your wife. Don't look at your wife. Look at me. I don't want to get you in trouble, Deacon Neal. But you know, your wives, they might mention something. Yeah, they might mention something, then they mention it in the morning. They come across again, they mention it again. When they pass by a certain thing on the street, they'll bring it up to their mind. You know what I mentioned to you the other day? You know, keep on keeping on. Then after a while, you without you even knowing it, you find yourself going that direction. Thank you. You find yourself going to that same store you say you wasn't going to. Y'all don't hear me? You find yourself, amen, saying, trying to figure out, can I fit it in the budget? You see what I'm saying? You find yourself, amen, trying to get whatever you can get, because they keep on bringing it up. And you get tired of, thank y'all. Y'all say it. I ain't say it. You get tired of hearing it. Y'all don't hear me? But it's the same way it works in the natural. Woo, hallelujah. It'll work in the spiritual. Honey, it'll work even better in the spiritual because, amen, we serve a God don't have no judgment. God don't condemn us. God that loves us and that God that cares about us. Persistent prayer takes you to the place where God can do great work for you and show you your commitment to him. I come by to tell you this morning, stay committed. Stay committed. Thirdly, Persistent prayer breaks the resistance. It breaks the resistance. When you pray, you turn loose the power of heaven in your life. Prayer can also, let me help you this morning. Prayer can also release the storms against you. Y'all don't hear me. I said, when you pray, it can turn loose heaven. But also, when you pray, the enemy can get mad and release forces against you. The heaven, the kingdom of darkness will do everything it can do to delay and to resist your prayer. But Daniel, the Bible tells us about Daniel, was a powerful character in the Old Testament. He was a mighty man of God, a prayer whom God used and again. But God gave Daniel prophetic insight into the world around him. And Daniel, he received a revelation. He didn't understand it. He begins to seek the Lord for understanding. He continued in prayer, but listen here, but no answer came. He continued in prayer. He prayed, but no answer came. And finally, the angel appeared to Daniel and said, he says to him, God answered your prayer on the day you prayed, Daniel. But a spiritual battle was raging, amen, for 21 days in the heavens between the kingdom of darkness and the Lord, holy angels. They were fighting. God had already answered your prayer and had released it. But the evil forces of the world blocked your prayer and held it up. Y'all don't hear me. Somebody here this morning need to hear this morning. You've been praying, you've been seeking God, and God already answered your prayer. God already released your prayer. But the enemy is in the heavenly places holding up. Holding up what God promised you. But I decree and I declare to you this morning, you better keep on praying. Daniel kept on praying. Daniel kept calling on the Lord, kept believing in God, kept crying out to God. And I couldn't tell you, he cried out to God. The God shook the heavens. Woo, hallelujah. God shook the heavens. And they had to turn his answer loose. I couldn't tell you, that's all you need God to do. Amen. Keep on praying. God will shake something for you. God will shake it. God will turn it around. God will bring it to pass. God will tell the devil, loose it. And let it go. I don't know what you're praying for. I don't know what you're seeking for. But I couldn't tell you that your persistent prayer will take over the resistance of the enemy. And the enemy can't hold on to what God got for you. Somebody said, I've been praying that I get rid of all these debts. I'm in a financial situation. But honey, you better keep on praying. And God can shake loose the power of the enemy. Let me get on out of here this morning. But we were bringing our request to God. God, day by day, he continued to bring requests to him. We honor God to show God our commitment. We break through the resistance of Satan. And what prayer have you given up on this morning? Whatever you prayed for, and when you didn't get an answer, you stopped praying. Is God calling you to go back? Go back and keep on praying. I want to challenge you this morning that to be in persistent prayer. Maybe you prayed in January and it didn't happen. And here you are down in December, the first Sunday in December. But I come to tell you that God still is on the throne. And imagine what happened if you brought your prayer to God daily and God is faithfully claimed to you the answer. I want to challenge you this morning to continue to pray until God answer your prayer. Until God come and see about you. Because there's three reasons I'm going to get out of here that God will answer your prayer. Some say, Pastor, how do you know that? There's three reasons, because I want to let you know that the goodness of God. That God is a good God. Yes, he is. And we should remain steadfast in prayer life, because the God whom we serve is truly a good God. Can I get a witness this morning that God is a good God? Has he been good to anybody here this morning? The text said the goodness of God is most clearly seen in the question. And then the question says, and shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them? Notice the two false assumptions we fight, that God is not fair. Y'all don't hear me. And that God does not care. But I come to tell you, is your God a good God? I come to let you know that my God is a good God.
And if he's truly a good God, then he keep on knocking on the door of prayer. And he's worthy of the praise. And he's worthy of your persistence. And because I know that God is a good God, and that God want to give me the good things here on planet Earth, then I got to keep on praying and keep on trusting in the name of the Lord. Secondly, the greatness of God. God is great. Anybody know that God is great? I tell you that he will come speedily to avenge you. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, he shall find faith on the earth, because we remain steadfast in prayer, because God whom we serve is a great God. It refers to him being a great God because he is the Son of Man with authority that extends above every ruler, every king, every judge, every power, every authority. God is sovereign. He's not equal to nobody. So here's the topic today. If an earthly judge who neither fears God or man can change his mind, when the widow woman persists, how much more will a sovereign God in his majestic creation answer the prayers of his children? I'm telling you this morning that God is great and he's worthy to be praised. He's a good God. He's a great God and he's worthy to be praised. Good morning, Calvary. I'm going to my seat, and not only he's a good God, not only he's a great God, but thirdly, God get the glory. God get the glory. How do you say that God get the glory? Yeah, because the text says, nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, he shall find faith in the earth. If we remain steadfast in prayer, because whom the God we serve, God will get the glory. God will get the honor. God will get the praise. God will be magnified. What you're going through is not just for you, but that God get the glory, that God can show forth his power. Because if somebody see what the Lord done for you, they'll say to themselves, that's a mighty God that they serve. They'll say to themselves, that's a great God that they serve. They'll say to themselves, if God did it for them, he can do it for me. They'll say to themselves, what a mighty God that we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. I don't know who you are this morning, but God is a good God. God is a great God. God is a mighty God. Ain't he all right? Just stay there. Stay there. Stay there. In prayer. Stay there. Calling on the Lord. Stay there. Leaning on the Lord. Stay there. Depending on the Lord. Stay there. Trusting in the Lord. Stay there. Waiting on the Lord. Stay there. Knowing that God is. Stay there. Knowing that he's able. Stay there. Knowing that he will. Stay there. Knowing that he show up. After a while, by and by, it's going to be all right. I'm going to wait on him. I'm going to wait on him. I got to wait on him. I got to lean on him. I got to depend on him. I got to wait till my faith turn around. I got to wait till God show me favor. I got to wait till God show up. Wait on him. Yeah. Yeah. Woo! Hallelujah! 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 Yeah! Wait on him! Wait on him! Wait on him! Wait on him! What you need, God got it. What you been praying for, God got it. It might not happen when you think it ought to happen, but stay there. Stay there. Don't you move. Don't you give up. Don't you throw in the towel. But stay right there. Don't care who laughing at you. Don't care who giggling at you. Don't care who looking funny at you. But stay right there. Stay altar. Hold on to the altar and tell God, I ain't gonna turn loose. I ain't gonna turn loose. I ain't gonna turn loose until you bless me. I ain't gonna turn loose till you deliver me. I ain't gonna turn loose till you heal me. I ain't gonna turn loose till you give me a breakthrough. Yeah! Power, 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 power in prayer. Is there anybody here on this morning know the power of persistent prayer? Know the power of persistent prayer? How do you know? Can I just testify that I know? I know that I know that I know that I know that I wouldn't be here today if the Lord hadn't gave me my answer. I wouldn't survive if the Lord hadn't brought me through. I'd still be in the valley, but look at me now. God, reach way down. God, reach way down. God, reach way down and pick me up and turn me around. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Yeah, power, woo! The power, the power of persistent prayer, the power of persistent prayer over resistance. There's power in persistent prayer. I got this word, I got some more, but I'm gonna quit right there. Woo! I might have to come back to part two, y'all, because I got some more to tell about this. Woo! Woo! I'm trying to quit, but I gotta tell somebody this morning that somehow, I made it, somehow. Somehow, yeah, somehow you made it. Somehow you survived. Somehow. Somebody say, how do you make it? How do you make it? Can I tell you before I leave you that prayer work for me. Prayer work for me. Prayer work for me. Prayer work for me. I was sick, couldn't get well, but I got on my knees and called. Call on the Lord. Anybody ever called on him? Anybody ever called on him? Anybody ever called on him? I done called on him. I done called on him. Call 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 on him. Grandmama them used to call on him. Call on him. Grandmama used to call on him. Way down in the cotton field. They called on him. They called on him. Say, Lord, 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 have mercy on him. great grandmama them called on him. We got to call on him too. And look what God did for grandmama them and doing for us now. Y'all don't hear me. Grandma prayed that maybe, Lord, I won't see it happen, but Lord, if you don't do it for me, do it for my children. And my children's, y'all ain't caught it yet. Some of us, we live in our grandmama's prayer. Woo, thank you, Lord. They know how to pray. They didn't have much of an education. They didn't have much, amen, background. And their words weren't quite so fixed right. But they could say, Lord, fix it for me.
All right.
They couldn't get the English together. They could got the words all crossed up sometimes. But they knew what they were talking about. Woo! And the Lord knew what they were talking about.
Yes.
And God answered their prayers. Some of you, where you at today? Some of you standing today because of them prayers. Some of you got out of some stuff because of them prayers. Y'all don't hear me. Woo! Hallelujah. And how dare we come to the house of the Lord and afraid to lift our hands and tell God, thank you. The power of persistent prayer over resistance. You got to keep on praying. Amen. The Lord said this ain't come back next Sunday. Now, I'll go ahead and finish this on up. I couldn't get it all in today, but I got a little more taste of it. Amen. The power of persistence prayer. This woman kept going back. And after a while, he didn't want to do it. There's some jobs that you want that you keep on applying for. They see your name, keep on looking at your name, but keep going and keep applying. Some things you want in life, but keep on praying, keep on showing up, keep on. And I declare and decree that God that I serve, if I know God like I do, and I know him, he done brought me from a mighty long way. Y'all don't hear me. I didn't just get in this thing yesterday, but I've been saved since 1979. That's a long time. Y'all don't hear me. I'm 50, almost be 58 years old next year. And the Lord done brought me from a mighty, mighty long way. Y'all don't hear me. I know what prayer can do. Y'all don't hear me. Somebody say, Pastor, I'm living from paycheck to paycheck. I'm living from paycheck to paycheck. I'm barely making ends meet. But you keep on being persistent and giving up your tithes and your offering. Oh, you'll be surprised what the Lord will do. I'm a living witness. I ain't got to wait till the bill get there. Y'all don't hear me. I ain't got to wait till the bill get there. I ain't bragging or boasting, but I ain't got to wait till the bill get there. I can go ahead and pay it in advance. Because God will give you favor in your finances. Y'all don't hear me? I say God will give you favor in your finances. Yes, he will. He'll do it for you. I'm a living witness that God will do it for you. Got more than what I need. Y'all don't hear me. I get confused what I'm gonna wear sometimes. Cause God keep on blessing you over and over and over again. God will do that for you. And I ain't the only one. Y'all ain't caught it. I ain't the only one. I see what the Lord is doing here for you, and you. God, there ain't just going to be a God that blessed the pastor. But when God blessed the pastor, it pours out upon the congregation. And we got some blessed folks here in my carry. I tell them all the time that you can't hide money. Look like every month I see somebody driving up in something new. The Lord giving them favor on their jobs, giving them raises on their jobs, blessing their children, amen, with better than they ever had. Y'all don't hear me. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I look at my son.
Eddie and Sister Hogan with jobs that they sit at home. They ain't got to go out the door. Y'all don't hear me. Y'all don't hear me. That's a blessing. Yes, sir. You ain't got to get, all he got to do is put on a shirt, look like he all dressed up, and sit in front of a computer and a camera and go to work and talk to folks and listen to folks and make him, amen, more money than I made when I was at my job for 30-something years. He already making more than I made on my regular job. Y'all don't hear me. God will bless, not only bless you, but he'll bless your children. Can I hold some at the church? God will do that for you. Not only bless him, bless his wife with good job, with professional job. God will do that for you. But the prayer of persistence will get you there. God will do it for you. People living in gated communities. Amen. Come out the country. Y'all don't hear me. Come out the country. Brother Nathan, they living in gated community now. God will do that for you. And somebody say, well, Pastor, why you saying that? Because, listen, I ain't hating on them. I'm celebrating with them. Y'all don't hear me. Y'all don't learn this. Until God bless you with what you want, clap for somebody else. Till God give you what you want, clap for somebody else. Till your blessing come, learn to clap for somebody else. Look at Deacon Hart. Before he can retire from one job, got another job. Y'all don't hear me. Y'all don't hear me. And when he got the job, Brother McCocker, they asked him what he wanted to make. God can do that for you. Amen. But when you stay faithful, all this favor, all this blessing, right here in Mount Calvary. And we ought to, when we come to church, we ought to be running in and say, thank you, Jesus. The doors of the church are open. I'm going to quit. My time done run out this morning. Amen. But, whoo, hallelujah. It's the power of persistent prayer. If you don't have a church home, you want to make Mount Calvary your church home, come. On the Christian Experience, come by letter. Come as a candidate for baptism. Will you come? Amen. There's one. Say today, you need a Lord in your life. You're not saved. Will you come? The Lord, stand up for salvation. Will you come? If you're watching in virtual and say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me for all my sins and my transgression. Lord, save me. I want to live for you. I want to be a part of your kingdom. I want to be your child. I receive you as my Savior and Lord of my life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oh,
yeah.
Making a way. Lord, every day you make a way. Yeah. You made a way. Yeah. Lord, I can't do nothing to lift my hand because you keep on making a way. Made a way.
Oh, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. We thank God for, amen, Minister Eddie Williams have come to be a part of the Mount Calvary Missionary Baptist Church. Y'all give him a God bless you wave. Amen. Amen. We're glad he'll come back. Amen. To Mount Calvary. Amen. Be a part of the Mount Calvary Church family. To God be the glory. To God be the praise. And God be the honor. Amen. He ain't going to say much. His mama got him crying already. He'll be all right. Amen. To God be the glory for the things that he has done, the things that he continues to do. Let's thank God for, amen, adding to the church. Amen. Amen. We usually, way back in the day, folks, we used to come by and shake hands, but we just going to give him a good God bless you this morning. Is it all right? Amen. We love you. God bless you. Whatever the Lord find your hand to do, do it unto the Lord. Amen. God, just come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Give him glory. Give him thanks. Amen. An awesome God, and he's worthy to be praised. Amen. God bless you. May be seated. Amen. We're getting ready, amen, for our communion, and then we're going to proceed on out. Amen. Is there any first-time visitors? Amen. Is there anyone here this morning that's visiting with us first time? Amen. Will you please stand, sir? Anyone else? Don't want to overlook anyone. Anyone else? Amen. Visiting for the first time here at Mount Calvary. Amen. God bless you. Amen. We're just glad to have all of you here on this morning. Amen. Don't want to overlook anybody. Amen.
My name is Clyde Thompson. I'm from Emmanuel Temple in Thomasville, Georgia. And I came here with my lovely wife and my sister, my sister-in-law as well. And it's been an honor and a privilege to be in y'all's midst.
God bless you. Amen. God bless you. We're glad to have you. Amen. Big time. Amen. Big time, folks. Amen. Glad to have all y'all here this morning. Amen. Amen. The whole crew. Amen. Our drummer over there, family. Amen. Her crew. She got a crew with her. Amen. Amen. Her dad. Amen. Dad in the house. Amen. Amen. Dad to come see about his daughter. Amen. 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 God bless you. We enjoying all of you out here on this morning. God is truly worthy to be praised. Amen. Our hearts and minds are clear. Amen. We're preparing our hearts. Amen. For our... Yeah, we're just thankful for the Lord and all he's doing and continue to do. I said on last Sunday that my granddaughter Marie, amen, last week, the week before, accepted the Lord, and then the other week, this coming up week, Allison, amen, accepted the Lord in her life, amen. Isn't that wonderful? Amen. So we're grateful for that, amen. Two saved grandchildren, amen, that I ain't got to worry about. Y'all don't hear me. Amen. God bless you. All hearts and minds clear. If you haven't got your communion sacraments, Deacon Abraham Clemens is walking around now. Deacon Ogden's on this side. Just raise your hand, and they'll bring it to you if you need your communion sacraments. You didn't get a chance to pick them up on the way in. Just raise your hand, and they'll bring it to you. At this time, amen, Deacon Roy Hart is going to come and read our scripture.
God is awesome. And sometimes you just don't know. He's a good God. He's just a good God. I'm gonna say that, man, because I know I started out with one horse, and now I got four. Some people don't look at stuff like that as nothing, but I'm going to tell you, two of them just kind of walked into my lap. I ain't had to pay nothing for it. That's a blessing by itself. And when you need that, see, my wife, like, for her. She likes that. She wants to get on and ride. And so, you know, we trying to, I'm just telling you, he's a good God. God is good. You just don't, okay, I'm going to share this. I'm going to sit down. We have been trying to purchase a little piece of property in front of us. And the guy wanted way too much money for it. But it's his. He can charge what he want, I guess. But I kept talking to him, and let me talk to my wife again. I was going to keep it for my daughter. I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. Listen, and I'm telling you, I'm talking about, this is like 1.2 acres, but he wanted like it was a mansion on the property. Now, mind you, I'm the one that's been keeping it cut and stuff of that nature, me. But I went back to him and I said, look, we kind of ready to do something because my wife wants these horses at the house. We ready to do something. Can you work with me on, what did I tell you, about 40,000? Come on, man, you know you ain't said that. It was listen. What I'm trying to tell you is that he gave me a price, and we worked down to this price. That's the last time I talked to him. It was at this price. And when he come back to me, he said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to let you have it for this price. It was on the low, low. And the Lord said, you ain't got to tell everything, Roy. So, I just tell you, it was lower than what we was expecting. And I know that wasn't nobody but God. So we begin to read here in 1 Corinthians. And we going to begin to read at the 11th chapter, beginning at the 23rd verse. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you. The Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant of my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. Therefore, whoever eats this bread and drinks this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, not your neighbor, not mom and daddy. Let a man examine himself and so let him eat the bread and drink the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. God's word for God's people.
Amen. Let's give God a hand clap of praise for that wonderful scripture reading and testimony from Deacon Hart. Amen. Let us stand. Father, we thank you. Father, we give you praise. God, we give you glory for what you did for us on the cross of Calvary, that we might have a right to the tree of life. And God, we pray now, Lord, as we do this in remembrance of you, We ask you, Lord, to sanctify these elements that are going to be used for your glory, the bread and the wine, that it might be sanctified holy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 The same night Jesus, amen, took the bread and prayed over it, and he broke it and said, "This is my body that shall be broken for you. Let us all eat together." Same night he took the cup and he blessed it and said, "This symbolic of my blood that shall be shared for you on the cross of Calvary. Let us all drink together." Amen. Let us continue to pray one for another, for those that are sick, those that are shut in. Let's continue to pray that God will heal, amen, and deliver and set free. Amen. To God be the glory for the things that he has done and the things that he continues to do. Amen. Go tell somebody. When Jesus and the disciples, they had the Lord's Supper, they went out to the Mount of Olives. We don't have a Mount of Olives to go out to on today, but we do have a world that's in need of a Savior. Go tell somebody about the saving grace and the power of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. Father, we praise you. God, we give you glory. Lord, we give you honor. We thank you for all the things that you've done, things you continue to do, how you continue to bless, move by your power, by your spirit, and by your anointing. Father, we pray now, Lord, you look on those that are sick, those that are shut in, those that stand in and need a special prayer. You know their name. You know their situation. Heal, set free, and deliver right now, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless those that have given up their tithes and their offer, returning back to 100-fold. That's the building of your kingdom, oh God. Those that had a desire to give, didn't give it, didn't have it to give, Father God. Just bless them, to God, even on the next time, to be able to give unto your kingdom, God. And Lord, we give you name the praise, give you name the glory, give you name the honor. And God bless us as we go through this week. Keep us safe and covered under your blood, under your power, under your anointing. And now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth, now, and forever. And all God people say, amen. Amen. Remember, you don't have any trouble, but all you need is faith in God. Until the next time, be blessed and highly favored of the Lord. Why? Because God is.